microcontroller performance is rising. And one of the platforms that's making this happen is Renesas's latest RA8, based on the Cortex-M85. Kavita, could you tell us a little bit about what the M85 is bringing to the table?
Yes, absolutely, Bill. So the RA8 series MCUs are sort of sit in that crossover space between MCUs and MPUs, and they are based on the newest Arm Cortex-M85 core that brings a few new technologies that enable that performance uplift in both scalar and vector operations. Arm has introduced a new technology called Helium, which basically accelerates AI/ML as well as signal processing tasks up to 4x over the Cortex-M7 cores. They have a number of enhancements to the core, which includes a deeper pipelined core architecture, as well as support for branching type of instructions. They have introduced 150 new scalar and vector instructions that support a wide variety of math operations for signal processing and neural network processing, such as circular buffers, FFTs, support for FIR filtering, as well as image processing and audio processing instructions. How they do this is by introducing wide vector registers. They can support up to 128-bit registers, and a customer can use this register and populate this with multiple data elements that can then be executed with a single instruction. So they use this sort of SIMD architecture, the single instruction, multiple data architecture, to bring this performance uplift to the core. The RA8 series MCUs basically use this Cortex-M85 core running at 480 megahertz, so it provides that high level of performance for our customers' most compute-intensive tasks, and allows them that higher performance without having to switch to an MPU and sort of have to change their architecture and their tool chains.
Now, the security is something where you added additional features to.
Yes, that's correct. So with this new Cortex-M85 core, Arm has introduced TrustZone to this highest performance category of M cores that allows that sort of partitioning of the system between secure and non-secure worlds. In addition to that, they have introduced PAC-PTI, which is the pointer authentication and branch target identification feature that allows for the protection against software programming attacks for code that has a lot of returns and jumps and so on, which is more susceptible to hacking. It protects against those kinds of software programming attacks.
Likewise, you also have side channel support. Isn't that a new addition?
Yes. So I was so far talking about the Cortex-M85 core and the security features that the Arm has introduced with the M85 core. Renesas, security is a key value proposition for us, and we have built in a lot of security features in the R8 MCUs in addition to that brought by the Cortex-M85 core. We built in tamper protection, as you mentioned. We have DPA, SPA, side channel attack protection, as well as the tamper detection. In addition, we have built in immutable storage for the first stage bootloader that provides that very strong hardware root of trust. That provides that chain of trust across the device lifecycle. We've also built in our latest security IP that brings all the leading edge NIST compliant symmetric and asymmetric algorithms.
Now, on the power side, this is a microcontroller that's designed to be used in quite a number of different areas. Can you talk about new features you have there?
Correct. So, while we are providing all of this high performance for our customers, we do recognize that they have requirements on power consumption to reduce the overall system power consumption. There may be government mandates that are driving that need to lower the power consumption. Towards this end, we have introduced a number of features in hardware, like the DC-DC converter, as well as several low power modes and for in both active and standby modes. So we have standby and sleep modes, as well as low speed active modes, and also CPU sleep modes. In addition, we are building in several, we have basically widened the operating voltage range that allows our customers to attach 1.8 volt devices to this device and lower their power consumption that way. We have introduced VCC and VCC2 domains, which basically allows our customers to interface with 1.8 volt external components while running the rest of the device at 3.3 volts. So we've done a lot in terms of our architecture to enable that sort of low power consumption.
Now, the part has the standard complement of microcontroller interfaces, such as CAN-FD, and it also adds a camera interface. What would you be using something like that for?
So the camera interface is interesting because we see a lot of our customers who are building, say, for example, security cameras, or they are building your fingerprint scanners or barcode readers and those kinds of applications that require the camera interface, do not specifically require all of the graphics features and so on. So we made the decision to include this camera 16-bit camera interface to this device that allows them to attach camera sensors to the device to, you know, acquire the images that they can later process in some way.
So you have a fingerprint scanner example, but can you talk a little bit more about how all the various features now of the M85 are taken advantage of?
Yes, absolutely. So this is an example that I find especially interesting because it makes very good use of all the resources that are available on the R8 M1 MCUs. The fingerprint scanner, the function of it is basically to bring in an image through one of the sensors attached to either the SPI or the SPI or the camera interface, and then process these fingerprints in order to extract the details of the fingerprint from it. And it uses the Cortex-M85 core and the higher performance enabled by it for this fingerprint algorithm, fingerprint processing algorithms. In addition, we are finding that our customers are also using the high performance of the core and the AI uplift enabled by Helium in order to implement some neural network processing. This could be things like live fingerprint detection, which is trying to detect whether there is an actual finger that's being scanned right now. So Helium is, provides that sort of 4x AI/ML capability to be able to accelerate the neural network processing. This is on the performance side. Once the details of the fingerprint have been acquired, this needs to be sent over to an external remote server for processing or authentication and so on. This is biometric data, so it is very key for our customers to be able to encrypt this image and have the highest level of security for this private data. And so the RA8 M1 MCUs basically have all of the security, advanced security features that are required to be able to send this data, to be able to securely sort of contain the data within the MCUs and then securely transfer it to an external remote server.
Now, what do developers have available? Are there some development kits, RTOS support, things of that nature?
Yes. So all of our RA MCUs are fully supported by our flexible software package, which is our software package that includes all of the HAL drivers, the fully tested HAL drivers, as well as middleware stacks and RTOS. We allow our customers full flexibility to be able to use all of the infrastructure pieces that we provide and also bring in their own legacy code. We do provide support for Azure RTOS as well as the free RTOS from Amazon, but we allow them the flexibility to bring in their own RTOS should they require that. We also, of course, support bare metal implementations. In addition, we have all of the middleware stacks, wireless networking stacks, and so on, as well as all of the six, crypto APIs required for a secure application. On the tool side, we have a comprehensive set of tools, which includes debuggers and compilers and IDEs to provide that very flexible development environment. We have worked with all of our tool vendors and ecosystem partners to integrate support for the Cortex-M85 core, as well as support for Helium, both the Helium intrinsics as well as auto vectorization support to give that sort of performance uplift or to enable that performance uplift for our customers' applications. In addition, of course, we have our RA8 M1 evaluation kit that basically uses the largest package that we have available, which allows us to expose all of the functionality on the chip. There is native access to all of the pins on the device, as well as external memory on the board that can enable these high-performance applications.
Oh, very good. The RA8 looks like a very fascinating platform. Looking forward to checking it out. Thanks very much.